is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Before we get started with the video, make sure you smash that like button, hit subscribe if you haven't already, turn your notifications on. If I hit 10 subscribers by the end of the week, I'll be doing a giveaway. In today's video, I want to talk about this lady named Virginia Hall. Now, if you don't know who Virginia Hall is, you are taking a massive L, all right? This lady was a beast. So, after World War I, damaged nations are implementing expansionist agendas all over the world. There's a lot of tension between countries, and particularly Adolf Hitler's political takeover in the 1930s caught the attention of Virginia Hall, okay? So she decides she wants to play a part in this and help the U.S. Even before World War II officially starts, she decides she wants to, you know, do a little something-something for the U.S., and that's exactly what she did, okay? So she attends university, and she becomes fluent in Russian, German, other languages, hold up. So she became fluent in Russian, Italian, German, and French, okay? So she applies to U.S. Foreign Services, but because she's a woman, she is rejected, and she ends up moving to Europe so that she can work with various U.S. diplomatic services. And while she's doing this, she goes on a hunting trip and accidentally shoots herself in the left leg, and she has to become an amputee. But to be fair, that just makes her even more badass. And she ended up naming her prosthetic leg Cuthbert. Lovingly, of course. And she applies to U.S. Foreign Services again, but she's once again rejected, not because she's a woman, but because she is disabled. So, you know, she's got sexism, ableism, double whammy coming at her from U.S. Foreign Services. Initially, to help the war effort, Virginia Hall drives ambulances for the French army while having a peg leg while they were being invaded by Nazi Germany. And during this time, she's recruited as a spy for the Special Operations Executive, which is run by Winston Churchill. And here she lives under a fake name, fake identity. She recruits other spies. She facilitates jailbreaks. She uncovers information about German movements. She's a walking W. According to one report alone, her and her team killed over 150 Nazis, captured several hundred more, derailed German freight trains, they detonated bridges so that the German army wouldn't be able to receive supplies. And at one point, the German army actually classified her as the most dangerous Allied spy. While only being known to the Nazi party as the Limping Lady, she was at the very top of Germany's most wanted at the time, and she was never caught. When she returned home, she was awarded the Distinguished Service Cross, which is the second highest military decoration in the United States Army. Later, she continued to work for the Office of Strategic Services and then its successor, the Central Intelligence Agency, and she didn't stop working until she was required to retire at the age of 60. A quote from her actually says that most of her friends were killed for talking too much, which might help explain why we don't see much of her in our curriculum, why we don't know a ton about her, why she's not being taught in schools, but I think she is so awesome. I wish I knew about her sooner. She's a girl boss, AF. Virginia Hall is 100% an unsung hero, obviously because of the work she did fighting Nazi Germany during World War II, everything she did for the US Army and in Europe. I think she has a ton of inspiration to offer for women and those with disabilities. Her resilience is just out of this world. Like, oh my gosh. I really enjoyed learning about Virginia Hall. I think it'd be really cool to learn about her in schools. Like, who wouldn't want to hear about this, guys? Am I right? There goes my hero.